So drought has the potential to affect wildlife. Today we're here to talk specifically about big game and probably more about what's going on with deer. So when we think about deer, deer need quality forage. They have a relatively short digestive tract to body size ratio. They only have so long inside their body to pull the nutrients out of the food. So for deer, it's key that they eat the right forage and that forage has the right nutrition. Whenever we go into drought, plants obviously produce less quality forage. And when you reduce the amount of quality forage on the landscape, it has population level impacts.
Without sufficient precipitation or rain or snow throughout the fall, the winter, it sets it up so that we don't get the spring green up. And spring green up really is important for mule deer. And what that does is give deer really high nutrition early in the year when they've come off of winter range, when they're really stressed, you know, they're on limited resources. And without that, they just don't get that kickstart that they really need.
Their ability to get fat over summer allows them to have the energy to evade predators over winter. It allows them to put energy and resources into their young, in milk production and other things, and it allows them to have heavier fawns in the spring. So this drought has big impacts. It impacts survival rates, it impacts antler growth, it impacts all sorts of things for mule deer, and it's hard to grow mule deer in times like these.
When deer are at a nutritional deficit, that can actually have impacts for years to come. You know, they will have to bring their body condition back to a certain point to actually have fawns. So that can have a really big impact on wildlife in the state.
There is a lot about this drought that's completely out of our control, right? We can't change weather patterns. We can't change climate. But there are several things that we can do. We can make sure that we have good distribution of animals on the landscape by making sure that our guzzlers are full of water and allowing water sources there. We can make sure that we continue to do habitat work and evaluate those treatments, increasing the amount of quality forage on the landscape. If there's obviously less forage because of a drought, you've got to have more area, and that's why habitat projects are so important.
Through Utah's Watershed Restoration Initiative, as a state, we've been working with federal, state, and private landowners to improve rangeland conditions for wildlife. You need a bedroom and a kitchen for mule deer, and the trees become the bedroom, and they're a good place for them to seek thermal refuge and hide when we have really bad weather conditions. And then we have the kitchens, which are the open forage areas that have grasses, wildflowers, and shrubs for them to eat. And if we have a system that's out of balance, then we might have too much bedroom, too much trees. If you guys have all walked through the trees, and you know, when you're in really thick trees, there's not much growing on the floor of that forest. And so by balancing these out, then they have a bedroom and a kitchen.
We can continue to do predator work. At times, and we've demonstrated this several times over the past few years, deer populations may have initially been reduced because of the climate. But then after that, because of the way that predator-prey relationships work, they may continue to be suppressed because of the amount of predators on the landscape. And that's where our predator management and predator work comes in. And the division's been more aggressive on that in areas where we need to be than ever. And when you do all these things, you do the habitat work, you keep the guzzlers full, you get the right distribution of animals, you get the right amount of hunting pressure, you know, where there's potential for conflict, sometimes you'll actually reduce elk numbers because elk are more resilient. Reduce elk numbers temporarily to have less stress on deer where there's overlap. And if you do all those things, then when climate lines up to be able to grow deer, you're set up in the perfect way to do it. You know, you don't have those other pressures. You alleviate those other pressures and hold on and wait for Mother Nature. So there's a lot of active management, right? There's a lot that's out of our control, but there's a lot of daily active management that our biologists are doing of the things that are in our control to make sure these populations stay as healthy as possible and grow when they can.
This extreme drought is going to have impacts to our hunting community. By reduced food, reduced, you know, fawns, reduced body nutrition, The hunters are probably going to see less animals. Not probably. The hunters will see less animals on the landscape.
So let's talk about specifically what's going on with deer right now. You know, we peaked population levels from about 2011 through 2015-16. We grew a lot of deer, about 100,000 deer. You know, we peaked right there at that about 380,000 number. And since then, over the last 5 years, since 2016, we've dropped off. You know, we've lost somewhere in the neighborhood of, we're down, our modeled population was just below 320,000 this year. So we've seen that ebb and flow. Now, big game populations do this, right? They cycle. There's up times and down times. And through management, we try to minimize those harsh swings. We try to say, okay, we'll take off some of the tops so we can navigate and have, so that the bottom won't be as low. But what a hunter can expect this year is to see maybe fewer deer on the landscape, right? As the populations drop, there may be fewer deer. They'll also see fewer hunters on the landscape.
As a biologist, a hunter, and a wildlife enthusiast, I'm concerned that drought is going to have more than just this year's effect on wildlife. This is going to be a long-term situation for wildlife.
Speaking in terms of averages, may have some smaller antlered bucks on average overall. That doesn't mean that we won't have some great antlered bucks harvested this year, right? There are deer that find those key spots, that find that super nutrition and grow really big antlers. And you may have a great hunt. You know, we don't like to dictate how somebody's hunt's gonna be. What we like to say is, you know, go hunt, take advantage of the opportunity, feel grateful that you're able to get a permit. You know, work hard to be successful, and you may be successful and you may not be successful.
Even if it started raining and we got tons of rain and things just really seem to have changed, the plants aren't gonna respond. A lot of them have already went dormant this year. So it's gonna take years for these plants to, for the plants to be able to recover. You know, plants have the need for help too. So they'll take some time to regrow their root mass, which will then allow them to produce the above ground forage for wildlife. So hunters can expect to see the impacts from this extreme drought for many, many years to come. It's gonna take a while for this to rebound.
At the end of the day, the division doesn't want to define what success looks like for you. You know, that may be harvesting a large antlered buck. It may be getting out with family and friends. It may be just spending time alone with an opportunity to harvest an animal if you choose to do so. What we can say is we want you to come back safe, right? Tell somebody where you are, be smart, have the right gear, think through things, realize that climate and weather can change on a dime in the mountains.
We've been in a series of a lot of drought years over the last decade or longer, and we're in a real extreme drought right now, and we don't know when that's going to end. But as an agency, we're going to continue to do everything we can to improve conditions for wildlife, try to improve habitat conditions, try to provide supplemental water sources to make sure that wildlife get through this the best that they can.
We're going to keep working on deer. It's who we are. It's what we do. We've got a lot of passionate wildlife biologists that work for the Division of Wildlife, a lot of sportsmen, a lot of hunters, and just a lot of people who care about mule deer, who care about elk, who wake up in the morning and have since they were little kids thinking about these things. And we will continue to work hard. We'll continue to try to bolster populations and manage for the healthiest animals we can.